A group of workers estimate to finish a work in 10 days, but 5 workers could not join the work. If the rest of them finish the work in 12 days, the number of members present in the team originally is. Okay. So how to find out this? You know, there is no formula for this type of a problem. So no, immediately you need to get some ideas there. So what is that? You know, initially there are some X number of members in the team and they completed the work in 10 days. And they supposed to complete in 10 days if there are X number of, you know, people. But what happened? 5 people didn't turn up for the work. That means 5 minus 5 number of people are there. Then in that case, they are, you know, completing the work in 12 days. Then what is the value of X? What is the meaning of that? How many number of members are there initially? Okay, so how to do this? So here I will do one thing. See, for example, here all these members are having the same capacity. Okay, let's take like all these members are you know, something like a chitti robo. So how many chitti robos I have taken? 1 plus 1 plus 1 1 plus 1 plus 1 and so on, X robos I have taken. Robos means here men or whatever, you know, members, workers. Okay, X members I have taken. That means this worker can do the same amount of work, this worker also can do the same amount of work, and X member also can do the same amount of work. For example, in one day, whatever work this fellow is doing, the same amount of other fellow also doing. Okay, do you agree with that or not? Yes, we will agree. Okay, and here see, I will do one more thing. For example, one person can do one work in 100 days. For one person, one chitti robo is doing one work, you know, cleaning the road or whatever it is, eating banana. 100 days it took. But if I use 10 such people, 10 chitti robos I brought here, then the same work will take how much days? You know, then 100 divided by 10. Okay, and then it will become 10 days. Are you understanding? For example, if I use the single person, more number of days are, you know, coming. And if I increase the workforce, then the days will decrease. The number of days that are needed to complete the work are decreasing. How? It is inversely proportional. That I, you know, work rate, workers inversely proportional to the, you know, work time. Okay, that is how it is happening. So here, in the same way, what is happening? X number of people are doing in 100 days. If it is only one person, then what is happening? I need to multiply 10 into X number of days. Okay, it is like this. For example, for one person, that work took 100 days. And for 10 person, how many days? 100 divided by 10. That is 10 days. Okay, if I go in the reverse direction, for 10 person the work took 10 days, for one person how many days? So that means 10 into 10 here, 10 into 10, then it will become 100. So we got the same right here. So that is what I am trying to do. For X people it took 10 days to complete the work, but for one robo or one worker, how many days it took? 10 into X. Okay. So, for one person, you know, it took 10 into X days to complete. Okay. And I will take this situation here. What is that? X minus 5 people are there. So, for X minus 5 people, how many days it took? 12 days. Then, from this equation, for one person, how many days it will take? Again, 12 into X minus 5. Understood? So here what I'm saying is, let's take, you know, X equals something, 40 persons are doing the work in 10 days. So how one person, if I take only one person, how many days it will take? 10 into 40 days. Okay, here for example, If it is a 40 minus 5 means 35. 35 person are taking 12 days. Then one person, how many days it should take? 12 into 35. Okay. That is how we need to do here. So, what is happening here? I got two equations. What is that? Here also one robo and here also one robo. For one robo or for one worker, it took 10x days. And here also same worker. Why? Because all the workers are same capacity. Understood? Here also chitti robo, here also same chitti robo. So, here what is happening? For one worker, how many days it is taking? These many days. But it should become equal. Why? Because here also one person is working and here also one person is working and those two are same capacity. That means both are, let's assume, chitti robo. Okay. That means, you know, this should become equal to this. Understood? Why? Because you whatever explained according to that, it should become that. So 10x equal to 12 into x minus y. Then, you know, 2x equal to 12 into 5 is 60. That means x equal to how much? 30. What is the 30x here? Initially there are 30 number of people. So here initially how many 30 number of people, how many days it took? 10 days. Okay, if one fellow is working, then for one fellow, how many days it will be take? 30 into 10, how many? 300 days it is taking. Okay. And second equation, 30 minus 5, 25. For 25 people, how many days it is taking? 12 days. Okay. Here, for one fellow, how many days? 12 into 25. What is the 12 into 25? That is a 300. So 300 days. Okay, now it is matching right here. So that is how you formulate and then solve this. Okay. So what is the answer here? 30. Oh, 30 option is D. 5 men can paint a building in 20 days. 5 women can paint the same building in 25 days. And 10 boys can paint it in the 30 days. Okay, same work. Here the work is same, painting the building. So if a team has 2 men, 6 women and 5 boys, then how long it will take to paint the same building? So what is happening? So first, you know, there are 5 men. 5 men I have taken, and how many days they are taking? 20 days. Okay. And then after that, how many women? 8 women. 8 women, how many days they took? 25 days. And then after that, you know, 10 boys. 10 boys, you know, how many days they are painting? They are painting in 30 days. Okay. Then if I take the 2 men, 6 women and 5 boys, then in how many days they complete the work? How many days complete the work? How many days? Okay. This is the standard problem, you know, it will come in all the competitive exams. Whatever exam you take, it will come everywhere. Especially if you are preparing for the campus placements or aptitude test. Okay. So here the procedure is similar. You remember that, and in the examination, without thinking anything, you just directly use this, you know, direct step. What is that here? First I will try to explain that. See, here you need to observe that the capacity of the different workers is different. If you remember, you know, we in the same year, there is one more problem where, you know, X member did work in 10 days and X minus 5 did the same work in 12 days. There, the capacity of the members is not changing, but number of persons within the group is changing. But here, the capacity of the persons is changing. For example, here, if you look at this, you know, five males can do, you know, the work in 20 days, means the capacity of men is more here and capacity of women is a little bit less compared to here, and the boys is much more less. Okay. So you cannot compare, you know, you cannot club these and then compare everything together. So you need to, you know, separate that and compare. For example, here, 5 males took 20 days. What happens if only one male work? Okay, then how it is a simply, you know, multiplication. Okay, what happens if you reduce the number of persons in the group, then what happens? The number of days, you know, increases in proportionate. So for 5 members, 20 days, for one male, how much it will become? 5 into 20 days. That is what happened. 20 days per complete that work. 20 days for work for one male. Understood. That means here, okay. So within 100 days, within 100 days, you know, one male, if only one male is working every day, okay. So he need to work every day, like that he need to work 100 days to complete that work. To complete that work completely. Okay, 100% work will be completed, understood. If he is working like that, 100% is completed. Then, if the one male is working only one day, then one male is working only one day, then how much percentage of the work is completed here? How much percentage completed, we don't know. That is what we need to find out. Okay. So, these two are in the proportion. Whenever these two are in the, you know, direct proportion, how to find out? For example, if you say this is x. So, x divided by this right hand side equal to left hand divided by left hand. Okay. That means here x divided by here 100%. 100% work equal to this is a one day one man divided by 100 days one man. Understood? What I'm trying to write is, first I found out for one man how many days it will take to complete one work. So I have rewritten the same sentence. What is that? If one person working for 100 days continuously, then he is completing the work 100%. 100% means he is completing. Okay. So, if he is working only one day, that means within one day, how much percentage of the work he is completing? That is what I want to find out. This 100% is nothing but 100, 1. Why 100% means 100 divided by 100, then it will be 1 here. Okay. And here everything will get cancelled, only 100 will be there. Okay. That means here how much percentage, you know, completed here? 100 is how much? 0.01. Okay, in absolute term only 0.01 of the work completed, or if you want to write, then this is a 0.0 into this is only 1% of the work completed. 1% means 1 divided by 100, then it is a 0.01. okay, so instead of that I will write like this one. I will keep like this. What is that? Only 1/100th of work is completed. Only 1/100th of the work is completed. Okay. What I finally wrote? 1% within one day, how much percentage of the work is completing? This much. Okay, 1%. And if two males are taken in one day, how much percentage of the work complete? How much work they complete? How much percent? 1% is 1/100, 2% is 2/100, okay, multiply that, okay, then it will become 2/100, 2/100 of the work is completing. In the same way, if you come here for the woman, what is happening? 8 women are completing the work in 25 days, okay, then one woman will complete the same work in how many days? 25 into 8, then it is a 200 days. 200 days, okay. Then same thing, 200 days, if you know, one woman working, then she complete 100% work, 100% work. Then if she works only one day, within one day, how much percentage of the work she complete? Then again it is a x2 equal to 1/200 work. Okay, for example, if 6 such type of women are working, then how much they complete within a day? In a day, this is in a day. Okay, so if 6 women working, so in one day, how much they produce, complete one day? Here they 6/200 multiply with the 6. Okay,
In the same way here, what is happening for the boys? Even for the boys, one boy will complete 30 into 10, 300 days. Okay. And then one day may how much one boy will complete? One day may how much one boy will complete? Okay. Then it is 1/300. Okay. Without following all these steps, I directly wrote this. Okay. Five such boys I have taken. Five boys in one day. Then how much they complete? 5/300. Okay. That much they completed. Five boys. Okay. That means here, but now they are working together. Okay. In a day, what is happening? Day is common here. Okay. What is the common here? Day is common. In a day, we try to find out their work capacities here. Okay. So here, what is happening? You know, two males, comma, six women, comma, five boys working together in a day. In a day, one day, okay. In a one day, we know that you know their capacities have been you know equalized here. For example, why the hell I am doing all these things, all these difficult steps? I am you know, trying to bring them on par with everyone. Understood? For example, if the capacity of the men and the women are same, then you know. In one day, how much work is completing 1/10, 1/100th of the work? Then, but whereas women can complete only 1/200th of the work, okay? 1/200th of the work. Why? Because the capacity of women is less compared to the men, okay? There also, boy capacity is much more less than the men. So, we try to, you know, bring everything, you know, on par by equivalence. Okay, so here what is that equivalence? In a day, how much work they are able to do? In a day is the equivalent thing here for all these three. So here also in a day, this one is in a day, this is also in a day, and that is also in a day. So what is the sum of that? Sum of that is 2/100 plus 6/200 plus 5/300. Okay, so what is the LCM? LCM is 600 here, 600 LCM, and then 100, no, we'll go 6 times in the 600, then 6 into 2 is 12, and here 200 will go 3 times, 3 into 6 is 18, plus 300 will go 2 times, 2 into 5 is 10, so it will become 40, so it will become 1/15. What is the 1/15? 1/15th half work completed here. Work completed. Understood? What is the meaning of that? Here, in a day, you know, two males, six women, and five boys I have taken. All these people worked in a day. Only in a single day, how much of work they completed? 1/15th of total work they completed. Okay, 1/15th of total work they completed. That means, you know, this is always common. Okay, so for example, let's take this is the capital A. So capital A group completed, you know, capital A group. Capital A group, you know, completed 1/15th work in one day. So, Capital A group completes 100% work in how many days? How many days? Again, this is a, are you understanding what I am trying to say? Capital A means it consists of two men, six women, and five boys. Capital A group complete 1/15th of the work in a day. Okay, capital A, same number of a group, you know, if they want to complete 100% of the work, here not 100%, here 100% of the work, that means, you know, it will become 1. 100% of the work complete, how many days? Okay, so here, let's take how many days is the x here. So here, x divided by 1 day equal to here, you know, 100%. 100% is how much? 100% to 100% work divided by 1 by 15th of work. Understood? AI will get cancelled here. This divided by this, I am doing that. Okay, AI will get cancelled because the number of group is here. So here, x is how much? 15 days. Here, x is nothing but what? 15 days. So here, finally, what happened? It became 15 days. X is nothing but 15 days. Okay. So this is this much big problem. If you are, you know, doing, you know, stepwise. But in the examination, how much time is there? Hardly you have 1 minute for this problem. And this problem is, you know, always easier. If something is coming like this, okay, for example, sometimes, you know, it will come directly. Okay, one A is doing some work in 30 days and B is doing the same work in the 40 days. Okay, and then C is doing the same work in the 60 days. Then what happened? 2A plus 3B and 4C is doing together. Then in how many days they complete? How many days they complete? Okay. So, if you see, you know, the parallel between this problem and the previous one, what is happening in the previous one, what happened? Instead of giving 1A, 1B, 1C, what they given, you know, some, you know, 5A, okay, 8B and then 10C. 5 number of A's worked, you know, 8 member of B worked and 10 members of C worked. That is how they have given in the previous case. When they have given like that, then we have first, we need to first convert into the 1A, 1B, 1C. Okay, 1A, 1B, 1C. What is the meaning of 1A, 1B, 1C? If it is a 5A is 30, 1A is 30 into 5. 8B is 40, B equal to 40 into 8. You know, 10C is 60, C is 60 into 10. Okay, that means we want to convert everything into the single person. Okay. Of course, you know, same capacity, but that is how we did first step up to this is the first step, but here directly they have given like this and finally they are asking like this. Okay, and the next step is all this we followed. So always you remember, first you need to bring all the problems like this. What is that? A is one capacity, B is another capacity, C is of another capacity, okay, different capacity. So one person within a, you know, same capacity, how many days he is taking? Another, one person in another capacity, how many days he is taking? And one person in another, some other capacity, how many days it is taking? So you got here. And immediately, whenever, you know, this is asked, then immediately you write 2 divided by, for A, how much? 30. So 2 by 30. And for 3 divided by, for B, how much? It is a 40. 3 by 40. And for C, how much? It is 60. So write in the denominator. First you convert into the one person in the respective group. After that, you know, whatever asked at the end, you write like this. You write like this. And you find out the, for example, here instead of 40, I will keep 60 for the sake of convenience. Okay, otherwise, here I will keep 15, this is a 30 and this is a 60. What is the LCM here? 60 here. Okay, 15, how many times it will go? 4 times 4 into 2, 8. And this is a 2, so 6, this is a 4. How much it become? 10, 18. So 18 by 60. Something like 18 by 60, so it will give 3 times, this is a 10 by 3. So, finally, how much fraction you got? 3 divided by 10. This is the fraction you got. Whatever fraction you got, you know, you reverse it. So, it will become 10 by 3. Why we need to reverse it? Actually, this is in terms of the percentage of the work. This is a work divided by days. Okay. Then here when you reverse, then it will become days divided by work. Understood? So number of days, you know, taken to complete the per work. Number of days taken per work. So what is the procedure? You remember this. First you convert, you know, for every single person within the individual group having the same capacity. Days, 40 days, 60 days. After that, you write this a final one, whichever you need to find out. And whatever it is there, you write here. 2 divided by 6, 15. That means in the denominator, you are writing. After finding everything, you know, you reverse this one. Okay. So, this problem comes again and again. You remember this technique and then blindly you solve this. Okay.